The 10th Parliament alone approved 77 loans in total, amounting to $9.552 billion in a space of 5 years between 2016 and 2021, and approved government loan guarantees totaling to $124.79 million in the same period of time. This week, the House Committee on National Economy embarked on a 2-week exercise to assess performance of loans and guarantees approved by Parliament. However, the first week has expired with less work done as ministries and other government agencies which use the loans are grappling with accountability.
We're not well prepared. Like in most cases, when you tell a ministry that we want this information, they can even come with a summary. And yet this committee is interested in the detail. We want to know component by component. You told us you are going to work on this number of kilometers of road. Have you worked on them? If not, why haven't you worked on them? What was the challenge? So we need to know those challenges. We need to know why you have not done. And yet originally, when we were acquiring this loan, you told us this is what we are going to do.
Several agencies have fallen short of financial performance details of externally funded projects. The committee has sent away several agencies over failure to provide proper accountability of the borrowed funds.
We have returned them, let them go and prepare, and let them submit what we want. We have already provided, we have given them a guidance on what we want. And probably when they appear next time, that won't happen if they give us the right information.
Today, the John Bosco Ikojo MP Bukedi County-led committee started with officials of the Ministry of Agriculture when they had just presented on one project of agriculture cluster development project amounting to $122 million. The project was aimed at increasing on-farm productivity, production and marketable volumes of selected agricultural commodities, including maize, beans, rice, cassava and coffee in 12 clusters comprising 57 districts. But committee members questioned the progress flagged by the ministry.
Will assert itself or this mandate to provide foundation seed, reliable foundation seed to multipliers that will multiply those seeds and stocking and breeding material before the distribution to the farmers.
But I'm questioning the planners in agriculture in this country. How do you get such a good project with an objective of market value and you leave out Busia? Busia, whereby we are the only with the biggest market for maize export in the East African region.
However, the meeting was cut short after MPs complained of lack of adequate information to explain the performance.
You could see members of parliament, they are saying you are supposed to do a road in our, a chalk road in our constituency, but it's not there. So they are trying to avoid such questioning. And that's why we felt they have run short. Their report wasn't meeting the threshold of the committee as per the invitation letter that was given to them.
Based on your submissions and the motion that has been moved, I want to agree with the members that the ministry has not provided us with adequate information that will enable us to present the report on the performance of the loans in the agricultural sector. Specifically, if you looked at the objectives,
the story was almost the same in the afternoon when officials of the Ministry of Water and Environment were turned away for appearing before the committee without a single minister out of the three ministers in the docket. On top of that, even the permanent secretary of the ministry, who doubles as an accounting officer, snapped the meeting and delegated an assistant commissioner to account. Legislators were irked at the ministry for taking the committee for granted.
These are people who come for money and we borrow out of pain, because borrowing is not good, and the dire situation is that they should account, they should not even wait for us to demand for accountability.
MPs also punched holes in the submission of the Ministry of Water as it lacked concrete financial figures to showcase the performance of the 15 projects under the water and environment sector.
The theoretical explanations may not be in position to help us much as a committee. Like I said, we are an enabling committee. We are supposed to work hand in hand with you to make sure that we give this country information in relation to all the loans, the performance of all the loans.
Having only 1 week left to assess performance of loans and guarantees, the committee is considering seeking extension of the exercise from the Speaker after registering less progress this week.